A whimsical, fantastical origin story about a guy who does magic and makes chocolate, set in what seems like 1800s Paris type city, made by the guy who gave us Paddington 1 and 2. Could this be the holiday movie to top all holiday movies? Hey all, my name is Sucharita. Welcome back to the channel where we talk about movies and occasionally with people making them. Aaj, let's take a look at Paul King's Wonka, starring Timothy Chalamet, now in movie theaters in India.
You're the funny little man who's been following me.
With wonder in his eyes and a song on his lips, Willy Wonka arrives at a European town looking to make his fortune in chocolate. Alas, within the very first song sequence, all his money is lost to people trying to make a quick buck, swindling him down to his last two pennies or shillings or farthings. One he gives to a homeless woman, the other he accidentally drops down the gutter. So he's kind, but he's also sort of silly, not ready for real life. As he settles down to sleep in the cold on a bench, a burly man offers him a free room at a lodge. The hidden catch, however, is in the terms and conditions Wonka fails to read, landing him trapped for what could be years in the owner Miss Scrubbit's basement, washing clothes for eternity. Now aware the world will destroy anyone with a kind heart trying to make their fortune the right way, Wonka must begin to take matters into his own hands.
So quiet up and listen down. Nope, scratch that, reverse it.
That Timothy Chalamet is a wildly talented actor is not new information. From Interstellar to Dune to now Kylie Jenner's boyfriend, he is frustratingly good at everything. As Wonka, there's a clear intention of giving the character the Timothy twist, making Wonka his own, until someone tries to do another reboot 10 years later. The endeavor, however, is only partly successful. There is a desperate positivity to the character, which, while very cute, takes slight getting used to. For most of us Indian millennials, Charlie and the Chocolate Factory conjures up Tim Burton's dark take on the book from 2005. Freddie Highmore was Charlie, we adventured with him. With this 2023 aesthetic and styling, Wonka entirely sidesteps that version and goes back to 71's Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory, jiska screenplay khud Roald Dahl ne likha tha. The only twisted thing here now is a church, jiske niche chupke ameer log control karte hain power aur money ko. Harmless or innocent bachche are not in danger. Only Wonka's aspirations to become a chocolatier are. This new Paul King story has more pointed remarks to make about accumulation and gatekeeping of wealth, a message it manages to get across, but rather patchily.
Even
the poor.
He doesn't like it when people say poor.
Timothy Chalamet is a surprisingly nimble dancer. His singing, though, leaves a little to be desired. Perhaps not used to having a playback singer perform for you like we do in India, the lack of professional level singing ability also translates into a rather ho-hum overall performance. Fun and shiny only in parts. As he introduces himself in song in a market where he hopes to open his shop, it is difficult to care one way or the other, which is the overarching feeling I had after the film was over. Just like its lead character, the movie looks beyond beautiful. It's all very Mary Poppins meets Fantastic Beasts. Every little detail in the set is a moving piece. Every thread in every outrageous outfit is stitched in place with precise intent. But beyond the aesthetic, the writing fails to present strong conflict or high stakes to get involved with. You know the lady with the bad teeth is not going to be able to keep Chalamet in her basement forever because Olivia Colman, who's playing that lady, has been given those bad teeth. You know Keegan-Michael Key will never succeed in his nefarious plans as the corrupt police officer because he's at the receiving end of fat jokes. Hugh Grant in his much debated role doesn't even appear for about an hour-ish, and when he does show up, it's Hugh Grant doing Hugh Grant dressed as an Oompa Loompa. It's funny because he's posh, but that's about all the emotion the character generates. It could be AI and one couldn't tell the difference. Wonka lacks the sense of wonder that should have been its baseline. Instead, it's predictable and mostly unsurprising, the last two words one should be using when writing about a film that draws from such incredible source material. Perhaps it really is for a younger audience that's not burdened by expectations of what a good Timothy Chalamet performance in a movie looks like, and seeing the actor milk a giraffe will be enough to bring joy, or for an older audience with memories of Gene Wilder as Willy Wonka they'd like to relive. So, on a scale of 1 to 10, Wonka is one magic chocolate he makes using butterflies from a jungle near Mumbai, jisko khate insaan aise udne lagta hai. Batao, 13 saal se I've stayed in the city, aur Sanjay Gandhi National Park mein mujhe itni mili aisi koi tilismi titli kabhi. This week, we've also spoken about Joram, starring Manoj Bajpai, and The Archies, starring everybody's children. Is video ke baad, wo dono bhi dekh lo, par subscribe karke jana. My name is Sucharita. Thank you for stopping by.